Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. From this tutorial, we will be learning about Tailwind CSS. Now, what is this Tailwind CSS? The definition of Tailwind CSS is a collection of utility classes related to stylizing your HTML elements, like, you know, those buttons, margin and padding, keeping up with form elements, or each and every form buttons present there, or setting some display, or float properties of an HTML element, and many things. Those are practically being used in case of stylizing your elements, your HTML elements. So basically, Tailwind CSS is a collection of utility classes which is practically related to your stylizing your HTML elements. Now, this means you do not need to create additional classes in your CSS. You may practically skip that part. You need to link your page with Tailwind and you can immediately start with various classes defined into it. Now, Tailwind is practically a low-level responsive framework. It is not a UI kit. It has no built-in theme. And it has no JavaScript extension to work with. So in case if you are mainly concerned about the look of your website, then perhaps you may go for this Tailwind CSS. But if you are concerned about various utilities and extensions, all those things are practically ignored in Tailwind CSS. It is responsive to the code. That means this is a utility first framework that is practically designed to fit into some responsive cases, and it is very much component friendly. Now, Tailwind is written in Post CSS, a tool which is required for transforming CSS with JavaScript. So that is why, in case of installation, if we now get into their official website, this is the official website of Tailwind CSS that we are currently seeing over here. All you need to do, you need to get to Google and you need to type this Tailwind CSS, and immediately in the first case, you will be practically reaching to their official website, where you will be having any kind of guidance and documentation enlisted there. Now, this is the part that we need to know next, the part of this installation. So in case of Tailwind, as I have told you previously, that it is a post CSS method practically. And in case if you want to add Tailwind to your CSS, then the very first thing that you need to know how to install Tailwind via NPM. Now, this is the part that we are practically going to skip over here. We are practically discussing about some basic features, some basic layout properties, some basic components, some basic features, those you may use with the Tailwind CSS. So we'll be practically skipping this particular part of installing it via the NPM and adding all those directives, injecting all those directives into your project. So in case if you want to add this Tailwind to your CSS and if you want to work with all those directives, then all you need to do, you need to install it via your NPM. And you need to install all those, those installer package, JSON packages. Then you need to do many more things. Lots of stuffs are out there. So we'll be discussing on all those things into some later chapters, into some later tutorials. But first of all, let's know about the basic features, those been described into Tailwind. Now, the only option that we are left with over here is installing Tailwind via CDN. But this is the part that we will be having some kind of difficulties, because we will be having to work in a featured or limited environment, such as we cannot customize. This is the first thing we have seen in our previous cases, that in Bootstrap or in Materialize or in such cases, we were practically able to customize their own theme and turn them into ours. We practically customize their codings, we added CSS classes into our project, and then we had used it. We had worked along with all those at the rate of media queries. In case of our previous tutorials, we have seen how to do with it. But this is the part that will be skipped over here for some particular feature, for some particular components. we practically are unable to customize, to add some particular classes and to use them into our project, to make some alteration into our project. So unfortunately, if we have to use the Tailwind CDN, then possibly we cannot customize it. We need to depend on the layout and all those classes, those being defined in Tailwind CSS. So what are those exact things that we are going to miss over here? We cannot customize Tailwind's default theme. We cannot use any kind of directives. On the other hand, we cannot enable features like group hover, or we cannot install any kind of third-party plugins. So all those things are practically the restrictions. Those are practically restricting us in proper customization and properly use Tailwind. But right now, all we are going to do, if we wish to know Tailwind, know about its features, about its components, then all we need to do, we need to know about each and every modules of them properly. So that is why in this particular case, we will be first of all copying the CDN from here. We have copied the CDN, and in this particular case, we have created a folder, a root directory, which is known as project. Inside this root directory, we have created another subdirectory, which is known as CSS. Inside this CSS, we have so far created a stylesheet.css, and separately, we have created an index.html out over here. So these are the things those we have practically created by this firm in an order to save time in our tutorial. And right now, all we are going to do, we are going to use this particular Tailwind CDN into our project. You can see that we have practically copied and pasted it into our project. This is not so much hard thing. Anyone can do copy paste. So definitely use this CDN in case if you wish to not to make any kind of customization into a project. And in that purpose, Tailwind CDN is the most exact that you can rely on.